Hey guys, thanks for joining me again for episode 3 of my Bible study notes series. I think that's what I'm going to call this series. I don't know yet. But this episode is concerning the book of John, chapter 12, verses 42 and 43. Now the context, before I read out of the King James Version, the context is Jesus was in his prime. He's in his ministry, doing his thing, healing people left and right. And people who were part of the church, they saw what he was doing, and they were like, wow, you know, he's definitely sent by God. But they wouldn't believe in him. They wouldn't leave all for the sake of the Lord. You know, they wouldn't let go of all that they were holding on to, like their traditions and religion, really. And so this is the passage that's concerning that. Again, that's John chapter 12, verses 42 and 43. Nevertheless, among the chief rulers also many believed on him, but because of the Pharisees they did not confess him, lest they should be put out of the synagogue, for they love the praise of men more than the praise of God. Now, the studies I did were for the words believed, confess, loved, praise, and God. So, it says many chief rulers believed Jesus' message, but because of the Pharisees and they didn't want to be unmembered from the church or from the synagogue, they wouldn't confess him. So, what's the difference between believing and confessing? Well, upon my studies, I learned that believing means, you know, you have faith in it and you commit to it in your heart. But the word confess is like affirming allegiance. It's like a promise or a covenant, professing something, confessing something. It's a loud expression of approval or agreement. So again, it's really that allegiance piece. People saw that Jesus was healing people, and you know, it was like something radical. They'd never seen anything like this before. But people, you know, they saw it, they believed it in their heart, but, you know, they didn't want to get kicked out of their synagogue, their church. So they were like, whenever somebody would ask them, they'd probably be like, yeah, I see him doing stuff, but I don't know. Like, you know, they weren't proud of the gospel, you know, like Jesus was doing all this stuff, but they weren't finna be like, yeah, that's my boy Jesus. Like, people were denying him, I'm sure. Like, they were not, you know, really all in. So that's why we'll go on to the next verse that says, for they loved the praise of men more than the praise of God. Now, the word loved, they loved the praise of men, meaning loved is like to care a lot about, you know, loving much in a social sense or a moral sense. So a really deep care about. So people deeply cared about the praise of men. Now, what is praise? Praise means glory, honor, worship, dignity in. So they truly cared about getting honor from men more than about pretty much God's opinion on them. Now, I did a study of the word God in this case, and the word is theos or theos, and it means the supreme deity, divinity, magistrate meaning like a judge who administers the law. So people at this time, when they would deny Jesus, you know, not really, you know, claim him all the way, they would really be doing this because they cared more about, you know, people's opinions on them more than God's opinion on them. Like, and when I say God, it's like, you have to remember that God is like the ruler of it all. He's like the judge. He has the final say. So people would overlook that for the simple fact of wanting men to think they're cool. Like, hey, you believe in this Jesus cat? I don't know. Like, you know, they wouldn't say yes. And you know, it's kind of wild. People still do this, I would say. But, I mean, you know, God's grace runs deep. So, you know, it's never too late. If you haven't received Jesus yet, you can do it. You know, it's not too late until it's too late. So, definitely, you know, just be encouraged, guys. Like, people, you know, they wouldn't confess him. They wouldn't have that, they wouldn't affirm allegiance to Jesus. But I just want to encourage you guys to do that today. Don't be afraid to say, oh yeah, you know what, I do believe in Jesus. You know, I confess him with my mouth. I believe in him in my heart. And, you know, that's what it takes, guys. Like, you gotta know that you know. Like, that's what faith is. Like, you gotta know, you know, you gotta have faith when it comes to that. Because, you know, it's by grace that we're saved through faith. So to have salvation, you have to have that faith, you know. And, you know, God is good. So don't ever think that your faith will, you know, take you astray or something. Like, God is good. Like, when he says all you have to do is, you know, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, you shall be saved. Just trust him. Trust him that his word is true. You know, people nowadays might try to say, you know, you have to do X, Y, and Z and all these works to, you know, be saved. But what did God's word say? It said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, thou shalt be saved. And from that, if you truly believe and you're confirming your allegiance to him, any works that the Holy Spirit have you do, it's just a natural result. Like, you shouldn't be striving to, like, do work more than just striving to be in his presence, in the Lord's presence, or, you know, led by the Holy Spirit. Like, that's what you should focus on, not doing X, Y, Z in order to get salvation. So I think it comes down to a focus change, I would say. But again, we read from John chapter 12, verses 42 and 43. And again, I really just want to encourage you guys that God is good. And don't be afraid to confess and affirm allegiance to the Lord Jesus Christ. You guys have a nice night. Thanks for watching the video. Love you all.